Try something a little upbeat before his drive is completely into the ground. Oof. This way. Okay. This is called Enter Fortum Bras, who, as I need to be reminded, is a character in Hamlet. So I'm an English professor. I get to say things like that. My mother would be so proud of me. Enter Fortum Bras. I like to think our lives are the enduring kind, ones the future will marvel over from their sustenance tubes, as we marvel now at those batty squiggles in the desert, the untranslatable pleas to any number of gods long scared off. It can't all be trash, can it? Misremembered, mishandled, improperly recycled. The quality of mercy is not strained, there's like lumps in it. No need to get all wussy about the botched prisms of your negotiations with the darkling hollyhocks. You're not alone, bucko. So join me for a lorn nip of some syrupy aperitif, the last dramatic persona among the walking stiffs. The slings and thongs of outrageous fortune, well, no need to kill yourself over every bomb and extinction. To be or not to be, what's the big diff? The kindergarten still rattles away with kinder until the sun explodes its finger-painted splotch, covering the stage with defunct fakers until some yahoo comes on to say he'll explain everything. He who doesn't have a clue, or far too many. Okay, I'm gonna do two more poems, and one is kind of long. It's like one of the longest poems I've ever written, which is like, I know to sit in an audience and hear somebody say that, it's just your heart plummets. Because, you know, the best thing about poetry is it ends. It just ends all the time. The line ends, the stanza ends, the poem ends, and, you know, we really shouldn't have indexes of first lines, we should have indexes of last lines. Because that's what we're all trying to get. You know, the middle is there just to figure out how far the beginning needs to be away from the end. So this is, you know, and this is, when Wordsworth was working on the Prelude, he wrote in a letter that it was unheard of that a man should write so much about himself, and I sort of feel the same way about this poem, although the Lord knows that other people have done it. It's called Man Overboard. I would like to thank you for my life, mother, friends, wife, flirtations, vexations, crazinesses, those vacations at Stone Harbor, with my dad traipsing up the beach to the bowling alley for pizza burgers. Of all that time only remained the sand in me, scrubbed, rough, insanely flipped, calmly, constantly rearranged by typhoon and volleyballer. Stone Harbor so developed, expanded, hotels where dune grass was, the beach that used to be exclusively the nuns where I had one of my first erotic upheavals, their habits surrendering and combating the frothy Neoplatonic surf, is now public, though the bird sanctuary with its coin-op binoculars still has its lenses full of cranes and red-winged blackbirds on the trash cans. I thank that chevron on the wing for fostering an aesthetic sense that beauty wasn't extraneous but a part of flying. Don't fly from me, life, but I know you must, as flying is your modus operandi in the chest, in the rabbit's nest, liver spotting, bending until breaking, making mother's brain unable to remember me, crying unusually, coming out during thunderstormy birth ago. We love those boomers sitting on our Pennsylvanian screen porch. Sometimes cruelty zigzagged between us. She was bigger, sure, could throw me out of the house during I didn't think a lot about until years later telling my wife, who frightens me, saying explains too much. Too much life. Flash crack, someone sees a shark and everyone out of the water. I'm sorry, mother, you were such a part of my life. I had to fight you off and out. You wanted other things. I don't know what or how anyone works it out. Shouts next door, I think they'll kill each other. Then edgy silence, maybe they've killed themselves. Then the world's restored to vroom, a new hurry. Let's go, class starts in an hour. Thank you, student who wrote about killing her hamster as a child. I almost cried too. The other student saying way too sentimental. Me raving, it's true. And the one who wrote, it turned out, about his father not coming back from Vietnam for the free association assignment. Use rhino, mountain, door, cloud, sword, and bituminous in 10 lines or fewer. Thank you, fevers, viral and emotional. Thank you, medals, menial labors, museums of wrecked cars, photos of volcanoes, girls in jog bras lapping me, tea leaves, trees, lacustrian nights listening to little genius fucks play Bach on the radio. Four times their age, and what have I accomplished? Does one take solace in a life that hardly detonates a flea or writhe and thrash frantically at the prevaricating rescue copter? Thank you, Sue, my older sister's friend, savior who scooped me from the deep end, gasping, pressing against her beginner breasts, ruining me with love for an older woman of 16. Later, when my heart swelled idiopathically, rumorous of failure, I thought maybe the challenge was not to go out screaming like someone stabbed in the neck in a fiery ball, but with a soft thank you, nebulizing like ejectum from an exploded star. Am I avoiding thanking God? My head turns mushy when I try to pray, so I fear that God's a product of that mushiness, but thanks anyway. What can it hurt for whatever part he, she, it, random particle motion takes in this continuing life, strife, and heights? Big box of crayons with scarlet already snapped, sky blue nearly a nub. Thank you all, sophomores, deans, queens, lustable afterers, frustrations, frettings, rose selections, apology mumblings, art making, forgetful non-phantoms who I grope and grill and fleece and ask too much of, who let me down and fluff me up, ask why I do these things to myself, half smirking, half helping, while I socket another million daffodils in the yard. And this is the last poem I'll read. Thank you for being encouraging and doing your best not to increase my embarrassment. Thank you, Tony and Tom. It's called Teetering Lullaby. Come to rest, my darling. The trees are autumn-twinged. The ocelot of my mind is out, would rest in the long grass. Comes to rest the bus in hydraulic exhalation. A puppy scamper wind finds itself over water and rests. Rest the future fires rushing, rest the past ash. The heart's adumbrations of bees may never cease, not the hopeful hum or peevish sting, but rest I would my hand upon your breast, sleep I would above the troposphere. No accounting for your beauty moving through me like a branch, a sigh coming from under the squeaky remnants of the old barn. Whatever's buried there that once caused such alarm has come back to forgive, to apologize for how it all went wrong. So rest, my darling, the journey's almost over, even though I've gone nowhere and never meant to stay there. Thank you.